Hey everybody, this is Review Group. We're doing a review of my 12-inch custom Archer figure made from the Hasbro Talking Archer. Now, my Archer figure is actually a pretty good representation of the replica from the actual movie. This Archer was custom made from the Hasbro Talking Archer. Because, first of all, the Hasbro Talking Archer is way cheaper. Secondly, I don't know why you would want to remake it when all you gotta do is paint it. You have to add a couple things to it, like his arrow pouch, his shield, his dagger, his loincloth, which I made myself, his crossbow, which also I made myself. It's not hard to do it. I mean, I know people got 3D printers and stuff, but I don't have one. That's why I actually took my Archer that I have and made him into a movie replica version of Archer from the movie. Now, he doesn't say the phrases from the movie. I wish he did, but it's still a pretty good figure for what I did with him. The dagger is made of cardboard, but it's still pretty good. The shield is made out of cardboard, but it still looks great. So is the crossbow, but it still looks good, all of it. And he does still do his sound effects. Really? Anyway, I did have it to where it was doing the sword noise. I don't know if I can do the sword noise now. I don't know, but anyway, either way, it's still pretty cool. But Archer is about 12 inches tall, like I said. He is fully articulated. Now, he squeaks when I move him around because he's kind of old. Hell, he came out in 1998. So that makes the movie Small Soldiers about, I'd say, let's see, 1998. I was born in 93.23 years old. But this is a pretty amazing figure that I did with Archer. I actually wanted to make it look a lot like the movie as possible. The armor I painted because I did not want it to look bland with just that gray color. It's a metallic gray on his armor. And his knee shields right there on his knees. Or gold to make it more authentic. But like I said, he talks. That's what he said. Of course, I have another project I'm working on too, along with Archer. I'm making the commandos again, but this time I'm actually making them myself. This is Link Static's body. I'm just waiting on Link Static's head to come in. But, it's very well done. And over here, I have Nick Nitro, along with two Gorgonites that I have made. It's Insaniac and, Frankenstein. But, this Archer has a lot of articulation. Like I said, when I move him around, he'll squeak. He's pretty old. And of course, I painted the belt buckle green like it's supposed to be in the movie, too. I wish there was a way I can incorporate the light down there at the belt instead of it being right on his chest. But anyway, he's still a really good figure. I did an amazing job on him. He looks literally just like the actual Archer from the film. He turned out awesome. I did an awesome job with the pale on his face, his ears and stuff. I painted him a couple times. I let his paint dry first and then I painted him again. And then Archer turned out really good. But yeah, I just wanted to show y'all my custom made movie replica Archer. I will be getting Tommy Lee Jones Major Japan soon. and I will repaint him to make him look more like the film. So what I'm doing is actually getting the commandos and making the Gorgonites myself. The Gorgonites are expensive. So are the commandos, but that's why I'm making my own, and that's why I bought the Archer. And when I got him, I didn't think he would work. I thought he would not work at all. It's just flat out amazing that when I got him, he actually works when I put in batteries. But I'm looking forward to getting my Tommy Lee Jones Major Chip Hazard. I'm very, very looking forward to it because I'm going to repaint him. I might do like a little nostalgia thing with the I don't know. I'll probably do a review on both of them when I get to Hazard. But I just wanted to show y'all my replica Archer. I did a really amazing job on him. Same thing with Link Static. My brother had a fit over it when he saw that I was making Link Static from a Major Chip Hazard that didn't talk. Like, it doesn't work at all. I opened it up, looked at the wires, the speaker was busted up, there was dirt all over it, and the body for Chip Hazard was terrible on this one. So I'm just, yeah. But I'm hoping everybody enjoyed this review, and have a good day, everybody.